Simply Don, the podcast network.
Don, this is Perry. The time is 8:45 now. I want to know where the fuck you guys are. I want to know what's going on with the spoons. I want to know where you guys are with this Slugworth guy. And where, you know, I know you're not going to tell me where you're meeting him, but I know it's somewhere out there in Chinatown. Give me an update, please. I want the fucking money. Please call me back. Okay? Thank you. Don, it's 10:30 now. Where in the fuck are you guys? You left my house a little over about 3 hours ago, if not longer. Where the fuck are you? Look, how far is Chinatown from Reseda? It's not that fucking far. You've been gone a little over 3 hours. Where the fuck are you? Call Tom immediately. Get to my house immediately. I'm the one that's supposed to be counting the money, not you. So get your ass over here and give me that fucking money, you prick. Capisce? Thank you. Don, it's Perry. It's 12:05 a.m. Where the fuck are you? And where the fuck is my goddamn money? Are you cocksuckers ripping me off? Because if you are, goddammit, I'm going to find a way to fucking get you put away. You son of a bitch. Where the fuck are you? Motherfucker. You cocksucker. Done. It's Perry. It's 9:20 in the fucking morning. Where the fuck were you fucking bastards all fucking night? I waited up till 3 a.m. You son of a bitch. You motherfucker. Where the fuck are you? You son of a bitch. I want my goddamn money. Don, it's a little after. It's about 1:42 p.m. Where the fuck are you, you son of a bitch? I stayed up till 3 a.m. last night, motherfucker. Where the fuck are you? Do I gotta go to West Hollywood to fucking find you, you son of a bitch? And this time I'm gonna come up here with my cousin Sam, because we're gonna fucking find you, and we're gonna get that motherfucking money, you son of a bitch. You motherfucker. You with me on the fucking gun. I'm gonna get your fucking head up. I'm gonna fucking press you and fucking head in. You son of a bitch. You motherfucker. You fucking son of a bitch.
Coming to you pre-recorded from Simply Don, the Podcast Network studios at a secret location in West Hollywood, California. It's Simply Don, the Podcast. Hello, people of Earth and other planets in the galaxy. I made it funny. It's your old pal, Don. Hello there. Big day today, and I wouldn't be anywhere without this wonderful lady. Put your hands together if you're at home for the very lovely, the beautiful Mary Jane. Hello, Mary Jane. How are you?
Hello, I'm good. Fine, thank you. How are you?
Thank you for asking. I'm fine. Now, you know, today is a huge, big show, right?
Yes, super fun.
Yes, it is. And the reason being, because today it's the first Sunday of the month. So who are the guests?
Don, Mole, and Perry, the big three.
Yes, they are. And today is a high-energy show. I don't know what to say about it. The Spain Spoons, everybody thought they were going to be multimillionaires. But, well, instead of me saying it, why don't you just listen to what happened? Mary Jane?
Take it away.
What we have here is today, it's the big three here. I've got Mole. Say hi to Mole.
Hey, everybody. Hey, everybody.
And there he is, the Scaremaster. Everybody loves the Scare Master. Scary Perry Caramello.
Hey.
How are you, Perry?
Where's my money? Okay. Where's my motherfucking money?
Okay. Hold out, and I'm sure you're going to be excited about the news. Okay? But we've got a couple
I'm not interested in your bullshit, Don. Where's okay. my motherfucking okay. money?
Scare Master, professionalism. Above all else, professionalism.
Keep in mind.
Supposed to be back in the middle of the night.
Oh,
where'd
really?
You go?
Oh, really?
Okay, stuff happened. Stuff happened.
A lot of shit happened. And don't fucking yell at me or I hang up on you. Do you understand me?
And show's over.
Yeah. Okay. It's kind of a test sponsor today we have.
We got a new sponsor?
Well, for my show, yeah. And what we're going to do is today it's the good
What do you
people.
Mean for my show? What does that mean for my show?
For a whole
look,
different
look,
thing.
Look, motherfucker. I'm here to talk business.
Perry, I know.
Yeah, but I want to know what
Perry,
the sponsor
I'm not here,
is.
I'm not a part of I'm your more... fucking show.
Okay, shut up,
business
Perry.
And money.
All right.
If you tell me to shut up again, motherfucker,
oh, yeah?
I'm going to have some part of fuckers.
Oh, really?
Don't hang
Are
up,
you really?
Dan. Don't hang up. Dan, don't.
Right.
I'm not doing your motherfucking podcast.
Gear Master.
I don't know where my
Perry.
Fucking money
Gear
is.
Gear Master.
Take it easy.
We
I'm going to ask you one more time.
I want to find out who the new sponsor is.
Summer fruit. Good
summer
people
fruit.
Summer fruit. So, like, what's your favorite summer fruit, Mole?
Oh, my God. There's so many. There's nectarines.
Yeah.
There's peaches.
Don't steal them all. Don't steal them all. I'm wondering, Perry, what's your favorite summer
fruit? I'm not
going
to be tricked into doing one of those. Excuse me. I'm not going to be tricked into doing one of your motherfucking faggot podcasts.
What?
Where is my money?
Can I right. can I say something? Can I say
yes,
something?
Go ahead.
Talk.
Can I guess what Perry's favorite summer fruit is?
Yes. If he won't give us an answer,
Scare
I'd like
Master,
at least
just say yes or no if I'm right. Say yes or no. Is it cherries?
Apples,
oh,
oranges.
Can I
we're not talking
oranges,
about fruit. We're only oranges, talking about money.
Oranges aren't summer fruit.
I don't give
stone
a fuck
fruit.
About your
cherries
fucking
are my
fruit,
favorite
faggots.
Summer we had cherry
I want
trees.
Money. I had you do something for me last
Perry,
night.
I'm going to ask
you came over
one
here.
Last
you
time.
Came into my fucking
I'm
apartment.
I'm going to ask you one
and
last
And that motherfucker
time.
Jumped
stop.
On my mom's credenza.
Who did?
Like a fucking leapfrog.
Who did?
You, that fucking fat
me?
Fuck.
Why'd you do
no,
that, Dan?
Not you, Don. This fucking guy, Mole, jumped on my mom's credenza like a fucking leapfrog.
Did you do that? Did you jump on his mom's credenza like
the
a leapfrog?
The whole night was kind of like a
fucking
dream,
God.
So...
You were right fucking there, Jagoff!
All right,
you
anyway.
Were in the bathroom.
Wait a second. I Hold remember on. I wanted to get close to the trophy for a picture. So I said, can I get a couple apple boxes?
Was anything broken, Perry?
No, thank
okay.
fucking God.
Thank God. Then why are you complaining like a bitch, man?
Because you're a fucking cocksucker! And
I'm
a motherfucker!
Sucker.
Yeah! Where's my motherfucking money?
Can I say something? Can I speak to that? Can I say something, please?
Please do.
For 1 second.
I would hope somebody would speak instead of yell.
It's,
yes,
okay.
please.
It's a relatively new thing. It's a relatively new thing. But I think the Pluot.
Show
might
me the
be
cash,
the
or I'm disconnecting. You fucking guys like to beat around the bush all the motherfucking time. And
Scare
I'm
Master,
sick and tired of this
Perry?
Shit.
Can I interrupt you for 1 second just so you hear what's going on? If you interrupt us again, I am going to hang up on you.
Don't hang up. Don't hang up, Dan.
That we
don't hang
got,
up.
I am going to say, fuck you, and
no.
take it from me.
No,
take
no,
it from
no,
me.
No.
You want to play my game? I'm in control. Who's in control, Mo?
Dan is. I'm sorry. Christoph is.
Thank you. Now,
you're not in control, motherfucker! Goodbye!
I'm in charge.
Gear Master. Well... I think you're in charge. I'm sorry that not everyone agrees, Christoph. Wait, there's only two of us
right,
on the screen.
Go again. Oh, okay.
Yeah, think maybe his Scare Master's internet went bad.
No, I don't think that's it.
Hey, Don.
He's
Don.
Well, I think
okay,
Scare.
I can't
listen,
see.
I think Scare Master.
I can't. Okay,
I
can't.
I think he's
see
a lot more professional than people give him credit
you.
For.
I can't see you.
Listen to me.
Here's the
okay,
thing with Scare
okay,
Master. I think
listen
he's professional. I think
you
he's a good guy.
Up,
he's got passion. He's good looking. He's got the Italian machismo, which people love.
Okay.
Thank you, Mo.
He's a great singer.
Up.
He's
right.
a great singer.
Thank you, Mo.
He's a very good
up.
Actor. And he's a wonderful oh. comic, skateboarder, snowboarder, and actor.
Thank you.
Oh, hey,
that's
Scare Master,
nice
back.
To you, but shut up.
I was just talking to Dan. I didn't see you were there.
You walked off very unprofessionally.
Is your internet bad?
Yeah, mine, yeah. I'm fine. I'm not taking this bullshit.
Okay.
Exactly. Well, you should talk to your internet company.
I want to see the cash right now. We had a deal.
No.
We
had
a fucking deal.
Mo, who's in charge?
I'm in charge, you piece of shit. Not. You got the fucking money, you fucking crook. Pay me what you owe me, you piece of garbage.
Dan's in charge. It's Dan's, Dan's podcast. Can I say something, please, Scare Master, so that we can move forward because we're stuck in the intro? So that we can get into the show, find out what's going on. Can we do that as professionals?
Please. Thank you, Mole. Yeah. Yes,
We never found out what Dan's favorite summer fruit is.
I'm going to go with cherries. Now, you said cherries,
I tried to tell exactly what was Perry.
You're going to have to listen until we get to talking about that. Will tell you this. I'll make you a deal. After this letter that I'm going to read, we will talk about the money and what happened that night, okay?
Hold on.
Yeah, pick a fruit.
Hold on.
All right, mine, while Perry's trying to do this hold on thing, I go with the fruit of cherries. Now, I know
what do
you
like,
you said
let me
it
ask
before.
You this. With cherries, do you like cherry pie, or do you like cherry vanilla ice cream, or do you like just regular cherries?
I like cherry
regular cherries.
Pick you like cherry vanilla?
Tree.
Why aren't we talking about the money?
We have a sponsor.
We have to be professional.
I'm only here to talk about the fucking money you guys are robbing from me.
Nobody's robbing anybody.
What did I say
was
going to happen?
Why aren't you bringing it over?
I'm the one
that's supposed to count it.
What did I say about what happens if you interrupt again? Now, I told you before, and I'll tell you one last time.
This isn't a show, cocksucker!
Why not?
Because I'm not here to do your faggot fucking show!
Well,
I'm here to get my money!
Can I say one thing, Scare Master? Since we are on the podcast right now, maybe now would be a good time to maybe... Dan, don't listen for a second. Get a plug-in for the skateboard company. Come on, Scare Master.
He stole my fucking skateboard company.
What?
There's no fucking plug for my fucking company.
Hey, great news. I just bought this scary SK8 boards name, too. So
okay,
I own two of them. I own two of them now.
Yeah,
how cool is that?
Oh, you son of a bitch.
I'm
you
not a
motherfucker.
Son of a bitch. I'm not a motherfucker.
You stole. You're a fucking crook, you goddamn thief. You're stealing everything from me.
Perry, may I get a word in edgewise, please? Because the best way to learn is to listen. And right now you're trying to do all the talking. Yeah, you know what the situation is. What is the situation right now?
The situation is you got all my dough, you got my fucking companies, and you're supposed to give them back to me. Everything!
Okay. Why would I give you something for free? Why would I do that? Why would I do that? And I said to you, I said a couple times, now this will be the third time, I said, I'm going to read this letter, and when we are done with the letter, we'll talk about what happened the other night and how you made mistakes.
Is the letter from Slugworth?
I haven't seen who signed it as of yet, so I don't know.
It's either from Slugworth or that fucking faggot.
Can I ask one question? Can I ask one question?
You ain't
certainly
the third.
Can I ask one question?
Yeah.
Why do you think they call them cherry bombs?
I can tell you why. Because
I don't give a fucking shit about
cherry
bombs.
It comes out of a round red explosive. And the fuse is straight like the stem of a cherry.
Oh.
That's why they call it.
Okay. So, I hope you don't accidentally eat a cherry bomb when you're eating your delicious cherries one summer, Dan.
Excuse me. What did you call me? How dare you use this kind
you're
of language?
You're a fucking cocksucker! That's why you're a fucking faggot!
Do we have to remind who has had a man's penis in their hands? Not me, not Mole. Can you say that?
That was a long fucking time ago.
Yes, it was. All right, anyway.
Yeah, but also you fell in love with that guy in Arizona recently, and that was just recently.
I never fell in love with a guy. It was
feelings.
It was a trick.
You had feelings. You sent him pictures of your ding-dong and your brown chocolate starfish.
Tricked.
Okay, Perry, if you're going to keep interrupting when someone is talking, first of all, that's rude. And second of all, I can't hear what you're saying, and I couldn't hear what Mole was saying. Now, what did you say, Mole?
Oh. Read the fucking letter. Let's talk about the money and then deliver the money.
Okay, well, you're playing by my rules because, Mole, who's in charge?
Dan's in charge.
Thank you.
Bullshit.
And can I tell you something? We found that out
Dan's
big time.
Dan's in charge of a gay show, Danny's show. He's not in charge of me. Never will be, never has been, and never is going to be.
May I read the letter, please?
Read it.
Can I say something before you read the letter?
Of course you may.
I will tell you, Dan proved that he's in charge the other night with Slugworth. I'll say that. Okay, read the letter.
Okay. You know what? I don't think we ever got Perry's favorite summer fruit.
We didn't. We never did. He said oranges, but that's a citrus.
It means nothing to me.
Pick one.
Well,
just pick a summer fruit.
Apples, oranges, that's what I always eat.
No, neither one of those are summer fruits.
Yeah.
So because what? Peaches.
Apples.
Peach is good. Peaches. You know, Scaremaster, I know you love peaches, but be careful. There's a big listeria outbreak. Have you bought a bag of peaches at Kroger?
I don't buy them.
What do? You go out and pick them?
Don't worry about
it. You steal them? You say you're
a cop. Don't fucking worry about it. Read the fucking letter.
All right. Don't fucking yell at me.
You remember Peach's record store?
Yes, I do. As a matter of fact, I had an original crate for
Peaches.
Forget
about the record store.
You know,
with
the logo and the crate, and I used to keep all. I may still have it, actually.
Yeah, because you put albums in it. You kept your albums in it.
Who the fuck gave me that shit? Read the goddamn letter!
What is wrong with you today, Perry?
You motherfucker! Where's my money?
I said after the letter. I've said it four times before this.
Oh,
read
hold
the
on
fucking
a second.
Letter.
Scaremaster, I know you love peaches, but do you also love peaches and Herb?
Oh, that's funny. Do you remember that?
Reunited, it feels so good.
Shut up, you two fucking faggots.
You know, they wrote a few Supreme songs.
Shut the fuck up, Don. Stop beating around the bush, you cocksucker. Read the motherfucking letter. Why the fuck are you fucking doing this to me? Why?
I'll read the letter. Okay. Dear Big Three.
Thank you.
Are you cool with this?
I'm cool with it.
Okay.
Let's see how Peaches is feeling. How you feel, Peaches? Peaches Caramelli.
May I please
read, Perry? Please.
Peaches and Scream.
By the way, that shirt doesn't make you look as fat as you did the other day.
Thank you very much.
I was actually talking to the Scaremaster. Dear Big Three, while your round mound of Reseda shit has reached an all-time high of disrespect for the rules in his ridiculous cult, in a real religion, they might have damned him to hell for all of eternity, but not in this farce religion. Instead, his Javajo... I'm not going to read that until the very end.
Yeah.
Let me just read this.
Go ahead.
His Javajo cult members just watched as he sends his dick pic to anyone that asked for it. Even though his elders have asked him numerous times not to associate with his adult film star friends, he continues to like and comment on their social media.
I haven't been on that for a long time.
Okay, may I read or are you going to comment on every little thing?
Go ahead.
Since I've last reported on your overweight con artist friend, he organized a high complex robbery from his one-time film producer where he stole his Christopher Columbus Spain spoons and the rare ticket from the 1492 trip to the New World. He even conned his friends into the very risky and dangerous bagman roles.
I didn't steal or con anyone.
Okay,
it was mailed to me.
We're going
to
talk about this at the end of this segment, and what we will do
is we'll lie.
Who's lying?
Whoever mailed this letter.
Okay. Does this religious encourage stealing from his fellow man? But that isn't the only way that he betrayed his sacred Javajo laws, where he wished various people happy birthday on Cameo. Oh, is that true?
Shut the fuck up, Don.
What did I do wrong, Mole?
Nothing. Did you wish happy birthday to people on Cameo?
I don't wish anybody happy birthday on fucking Cameo. I tell them congratulations for being born.
Yeah, but that's happy birthday.
Yeah, it really is. And from the Department
of...
May I please read this, Perry?
Finish.
And from the Department of Counting Their Chickens Before They're Hatched, your transsexual enthusiast has been spending money from the robbery before it ever even happened. Fucking Connors.
What are you talking about?
Thinking that the money was coming, instead of spending the money that his publicist gave him to pay bills, he treated himself every day to fine dining at places like El Pollo Loco, Del Taco, and numerous times at Gino
East. This is none of your business.
Pizza in Sherman Oaks. Did you do that?
Yeah, it's none of your business, though.
I'm just reading
the
letter.
It's not fine dining. It's fucking fast food.
All right, let's see if
this
is... Other
than Gino's East.
That's a good place,
What do you
right?
get at Gino's East, Scaremaster? What kind of pizza?
Gino's East pizza.
Yeah, but aren't you lactose
Gino's
intolerant?
Gino's Supreme.
Aren't you what? Lactose... Aren't you
yeah,
lactose
I take my pills first.
Oh, so you take the pills so that you can
lactate
eat the pizza?
Lactate pills, yes.
What kind of pizza you got?
I just said a Gino's Supreme.
Okay, I didn't know.
Chicago style.
Do you ever get extra cheese, even though you're lactose intolerant? Do you have to take pills before you do that?
Well, how many pills do you take?
Two.
Do you ever take more than two pills a day or no?
Get on with the letter, you fucking losers.
Did you notice how nice and neat
it looked?
Perry's
really good, Scaremaster. It looked really good.
Yeah, thank
it really
you, because
did.
I cleaned up.
Well, that's nice of you. You still get the garbage box?
Yes.
I noticed that his bathroom, because I went in there and relieved tension.
What do you mean you relieved tension?
You jerked off like a fucking pig. Disgusting animal.
Oh.
Just out of curiosity, if I ever do that again, should I release all the tension in the sink or should I try
You're
to
never
put it
coming
toilet?
Over
how
again.
Do you work?
Where did you put it last time, Dan?
In the sink.
Disgusting son of a bitch. You disgusting fucking pig.
Oh, and I had to go and risk my life for your dumbass pig.
You goddamn right! Now finish the fucking letter!
And Scaremaster, how do you know that sink wasn't in love with Dan? Maybe they're going to have sink babies.
Oh, shut up, you fucking psychopath! Drug addict, fucking pot-smoking sick...
What does that mean?
Sick bastard.
Pot's a legal smoking thing.
Pot is good, heroin is bad.
That's right. All right.
Finish the fucking letter.
I'm trying to, but you keep interrupting me. He went to the Ford dealership. All right, there you are. You just interrupted me again. Tell me when you're done.
Finish!
Okay, he went to the Ford dealership in Van Nuys to talk about purchasing not only a car, the Shelby Mustang GT350, but also a truck from
the... How the fuck do you know this?
How the fuck... I'm reading what it says here. From the F-150 series.
Wait, you're getting a Ford? What happened to your love of Toyota?
What, are you guys spying on me or something? And who the fuck is following me, spying on me?
You know what? Maybe if you'd let me finish the letter, maybe you could find out when he signs it.
Go ahead.
What the fuck, man? You make my life impossible.
No, you make my life impossible.
You're out of your fucking mind.
You guys make my life wonderful.
Thank you, Mo. You make my life wonderful.
Oh, thanks, Dan.
He was so serious about getting these vehicles that neighbors saw him measuring his parking spaces at his apartment complex to make sure that they would both fit.
How the fuck do you know this?
Is that true?
How do you know this?
Because I'm reading it right now. That's how I know it.
But how does he know this?
Let's find out.
Maybe in the conclusion, but you keep interrupting that we can never get to.
Yeah. I want to know how this fucking guy finds out.
He knew that after he got the money, he couldn't keep it all at his apartment because it'd be way too much. So he asked his cousin if he could store something in his garage. When his cousin asked him what in the world
how
he
the
would
fuck
be storing,
do you know this?
He told him in typical nitwit style, It's none of your business.
Oh.
Pretty awesome.
Not even your cousin's
business?
How in
the fuck do you know these things?
He's reading
them. You got my phone bug, don't you?
Okay, can
I read them?
Can I finish reading this, or do you want to keep complaining about nothing?
Oh, my God. You're scaring the shit out of me.
I could go on for hours telling ridiculous stories that this idiotic Italian has done, but I'll close with this. After Don and Mole pointed out how much weight he has gained during the COVID-19 and how disgusting he looks, an order was put out for Keto Nutra Slim Advanced Detox Cleanser and Keto Nutra Slim Fat Burner.
How in the fuck do you know these fucking things?
All right, it's almost over. You want me to read this or no?
Finish.
Has Dum Dum ever heard that not eating shitty food and exercising can help lose weight? And it's not a big waste of money like that other shit he's buying? Your fan, computer hacker, and former business associate, Hugh A. Craig III, editor-in-chief of Perry Leaks. P.S. By the way, Perry has never denied being gay, though. Okay.
Not gay, and I've always denied being gay. This guy's spying on me, and I have no idea how he sees or hears about any of this shit.
Can I make a suggestion? I have an idea. He likes you. He likes you.
Shut up, you flaming faggot!
A feminine faggot?
Flaming faggot.
Okay, sorry.
No, Hugh A. Craig III likes you, Scaremaster.
I don't care!
Can you
you gotta admit, it's
I don't fucking care!
Are you ready to talk business?
He's spying on
Are you ready to talk
kind
business?
Of flatter, kind of, you gotta admit, it's flattering that he likes you so much. It's a little bit flattering that he likes you so much.
Keep in mind,
show me the money, please.
I'm in charge.
Yes,
so
dear,
you will do this the
since
way.
You're in charge,
all right.
Show me the cash.
I'm not going to show the cash. We're going to play a little game with it.
Oh, my God.
Are you
I'm
a
not
betting?
Here to play games.
Are you a betting
man? I am
not
man? A game player. I am not a fucking game player. And get that fucking smirk off your face before I smash it over.
Because
before I smack it with a fucking skateboard.
I have
you
to laugh.
You piece of garbage.
Let me just say what I have to say. I have to laugh because when you say you're not a game player, but you're one of the biggest gamblers I've ever met in my life. Are you willing to risk a little money?
I don't gamble. I'm not a gambler. I've never gambled. Other than one time when I, or two times when I went to see my
yeah, but Scaremaster,
girlfriend in Vegas, I played slot machines.
Okay,
for
you said you're not a gambler, but the gambler, and but yet you went out looking at a F-150 and a Shelby Cobra, and the gambler says,
that's none of your
you
business.
Never count your money when you're sitting at the table.
How does that go, though? How would he say it, though?
You got no way to hold them.
No
way to fold them. No way to walk
I was away. Not gambling. No I was checking them out to
money.
See.
Money.
After pulling Don Deliver. Okay, let's do this. Do you want to talk business or no?
I would like to talk about something before that, if it's all right.
Fine, perfect.
No, I'm not interested. I'm only interested in the fucking dough.
Okay, well,
when you're
then that's fine, Scaremaster.
Then
that's fine, because right now we're not talking about you or Dan or me. We're talking about what's happening in this country with a system of inherent racism that is brought down on our
who
black
gives
brothers
a fucking
and
shit? I'm not interested.
Scaremaster,
I'm only interested in the fucking money you guys stole.
Listen, I know that you are a proud racist, but you shouldn't
You
be.
Take that back, you son of a bitch. We didn't steal anything from you.
You
no,
stole it all from me.
We
and I should have kept those fucking spoons and that goddamn ticket from 1492.
I think you did keep that fucking
ticket.
I think you did.
And you fucking threw it on the ground like it was
a fucking
Tonka toy.
But I did.
The goddamn box broke like it was a piece of garbage, you son of a bitch.
What I would like to talk about, Scaremaster.
Those spoons belong to Christopher Columbus. And the map was the ticket to the New World, you motherfuckers. Those were his spoons.
They were Christopher Columbus?
All right.
Yes.
Again,
they were worth way more.
What kind of stuff do you guys think Christopher Columbus ate with his
spaghetti.
Spoons?
He's an Italian.
Who the fuck knows?
Spaghetti.
Man. All that.
Well, but spoons by SpaghettiOs.
Twirling.
No, if I would just like to just make a statement, please. We are in a really bad place in our country, and
time.
We need to embrace one another, regardless of their
There's
race.
No embracing.
Scare
There's
message.
No fucking embracing. You guys are fucking robbing me, and I'm not taking
your shit.
I'm not
going to be insulted
yours
by you
or
again
his.
In about 1 minute.
What?
I am not going to take your insults anymore tonight. And if you do it again.
Are you going to boycott? Are we going to boycott?
What are you going to do about it?
Let's boycott. Let's boycott. Let's boycott.
What are you going to do about it, you fucking thief?
You call me a thief again, and I'm going to hang up on you.
You are a thief.
Bye.
No, don't do it, Dan. Don't do it, Dan. No. Don't do it. Don't
Show
do
me
it.
The money,
Guess
motherfucker.
What? Maybe I don't want to give it to you. Say you're sorry. Say you're sorry for yelling, all right? Or it's done. No more, Mo.
I knew I shouldn't
have given
you
a never.
You
know what?
I shouldn't have given
you
those
done business with you because you're a terrible business person.
I knew I shouldn't have given you
I
those
I just think
spoons.
There's more important things happening
I did
in
my
this
end, motherfucker.
No, you
I did my end. And now you're a fucking
right.
lying
then
fucking
let's do
thief.
This. Let's organize this in a way that we can tell the story. Perry,
tell
you
how about
tell
the story.
How about for the people who don't, the people who, the listeners who don't know what we're talking
Why
about?
You tell
how about
them
we
that?
Take it from the beginning? Okay, can I just tell what happened, Scare
Master?
Where
are you going, Perry? Look at his fat gut. Look at his
what
gut.
Are you talking
Look
about,
how fat
Mole?
He is. Look at that.
Scare
What are you Scare talking about, Mole?
Are you taking pictures of your ding dong again? There we go. Okay. Can I tell what happened
yes.
with the spoons?
Yes, it'd be nice to hear.
Well, explain to the people what's going on. First.
And I would like to tell it. First off, before I tell this story, Scare Master, you have to admit that Black Lives Matter. There we go. I'm glad you finally admitted it.
Thank you.
Thank
Perry.
You.
Perry,
everybody matters,
thank you.
Including
no.
black
No, not everybody.
For everyone
Only
to matter.
Black lives. The rest for, of us are jerks.
For everyone to matter, we first have to have Black Lives Matter.
You're thank welcome. You, Dan. Thank you.
That's.
I'm disgusted at what I see
I don't
in this
care,
country.
Whatever.
Hey, why don't you explain whatever. To the people disgusted. That have never heard this
I'm
before?
I'm from Milwaukee. I'm from Milwaukee, okay? And I'm disgusted at what I see.
Well, can you
okay,
tell us,
tell you about the
for people
spoons.
Like just tuning in, can you explain what's
I
going on?
I just feel we should boycott. I feel we
no,
should boycott.
No, don't.
We should
walk out. Well, I think Perry wants to get this thing over with.
All right. Okay.
What has Tom said about this?
Right now, I want to know what you're going to do with this fucking money. Tom's not too happy
Fuck
about this
that,
either.
Dude. You
Fuck you, you
take
prick.
It back. Take it back or I hang up on you.
All right.
I want to hear about the spoons. I want to hear
about I'll tell you
about
the
money.
Spoons. Can I tell
Please,
you about the spoons?
Mo, somebody keeps interrupting. Somebody keeps interrupting. Go ahead.
I just don't want us to brush past the fact that we are at a turning point in our country and we're in a really, really bad place with racism, as we've always been. And it's time to live up to the ideals of the real
Thank
American
you.
Dream. All right.
We're not
Thank
talking
you.
About that.
Well, we should be. That's all anyone
We're
should be talking
to
about.
We're talking about when you're going to bring over
yeah,
my money.
Well, what's more important? I think there's bigger issues here, Scare
my
Master.
My money's more
sports
important.
Sports or
you
Spain
fucking low lives.
Can I throw something out there? And I want
please,
everybody
Dan,
to
please.
Say yes, but maybe we should take all the money that we got from this and donate it to this cause.
I would do that in a second. I would do that
you
in a
donate
second.
My fucking money, you pieces of shit.
Okay,
and I
we will.
Fucking have you guys murdered. I want you guys dead.
What?
Because you guys are nothing more than a fucking bunch of using 28, 29 fucking years of using and abusing me. Every fucking time. Use me, abuse me. Use me, abuse me. Use me, abuse me. Fuck you all the fucking time. I'm done. You fucking cocksucking bald piece of shit. You're no good. You're a motherfucker. And I'm done with you. You pile of shit!
That was fucking
Show me the fucking
man.
Money!
You, okay. who's in charge?
Show me the fucking
I'm in
money!
Charge.
Can
I'm
I say what
charge.
Happened? Can I tell what
Show
happened?
Show me
please?
The motherfucking money!
Mole is gonna tell the
Show story. Me the money!
Okay.
Go ahead, Mole. Go ahead.
A phrase that was gifted to us by a talented black actor. I will also add. Show me the money, Cooper Gooding Jr. Okay. So the spoons. The, Let me tell you the story of the Spain spoons. Can I tell you the story of the Spain spoons, Cameras? You want to hear it or not?
Perry, you've been through it a million times. You know this is going to happen. Relax and listen, and it'll come up, and you will find out what happened the other night.
I don't fucking have a heart attack.
Yeah, okay, then settle down. Settle down. Everything's cool. Hey, trust me.
Uh-oh.
My video went out.
Bring that fucking money over here, you motherfucker!
My video go out.
Oh, they want to fucking watch me die.
Who are you talking to?
Of course he's... Yeah. All he wants to do is watch me die. You piece of fucking shit. I can't allow myself to die in front of you, you fuck. Hey.
Let me just say one thing. You will find out how you fucked up, and you are going to apologize to Mole and I.
Kissing go ahead, your Mole. Fucking ass?
Go ahead, Mole.
Kissing your fucking ass?
Can Mole go on so we can get to the point where we tell you what happened the other night? Mole, take it away. For the people that don't know what's happening here, explain what has happened.
Okay. We're talking about the Spain spoons, okay?
Yes, we are.
Okay. Now, the Spain spoons, in 1492, Christopher Columbus wanted to set sail for the New World. So he went to Queen Isabella of Spain and said, hey, I want to go to the New World because I'm Italian. I got to get out of here. I got some problems with some guys. And so I got to go. And so she goes, okay, you can go. But before you go, you got to make sure you eat right, Christopher Columbus. And you got to sell lots of tickets to the ship. So he sold the tickets. And so Christopher Columbus goes,
excuse
what am
me,
I supposed
to do? Excuse me. Blah, blah, blah. Why don't you just sit there and listen and enjoy?
I'm not enjoying shit! Show me the fucking money!
I've asked you to settle
down. I want my fucking money!
Yeah, I'm going to call Tom.
No. Don't tell.
Call Tom!
I'm going to.
I'm getting tired of this.
I'm getting tired of your bullshit. Mole's telling a great story, and he's doing
Dan.
Very well. And he's
Dan.
It incredible.
Finish the story.
Okay.
Let me just call Tom first.
Hello?
Tom. I'm
yes.
trying to talk to your client here, and he keeps interrupting everything. Is there any way that
How's
you
the
can
meeting
call?
Going?
How's the meeting? I think it's going wonderful. It's going better than I thought. But Perry keeps interrupting because he doesn't know how to play the game.
You lying fuck.
You're the lying fuck. We try to do something. You fuck us. You put us out there with our fucking balls in our hand. And you'll find out how you fucked us. Tom, keep your monkeying straight, okay?
I fucked you.
Yes.
My and I'm calling me the monkey when that fucking clown jumps on my mom's credenza like it's a fucking trampoline.
I would like to have Mole tell the story.
Thank God it didn't break the fucking glass.
Can I tell the story?
Please.
Okay, hold on. I've got technical problems. Shoot. Can you guys hold on 1 second?
Yes.
You're stalling. You guys know how
so,
to do
so
it.
Queen,
stall,
Scaremaster, just listen. So Queen Isabella goes. She goes, Christopher Columbus, you got to go to the New World, and I want you to bring me some summer fruit. And he said, what kind of summer fruit do you like? And she goes, I like peaches and apricots and pluots, and I like...
Perry said peaches.
Nectarines, I like cherries and strawberries, all kinds of berries. Blueberries, raspberries, boysenberries, blackberries, halle berries.
You son of a bitch.
I set you guys up.
Whatever.
So he goes on the boat, and as he's getting on the boat, he's like, oh, my God, somebody made soup for the boat. And they go, and the boat's about to take off. He's like, I got nothing to eat the soup. So she, Queen Isabella, runs out. She goes, hold on. I brought you these spoons. So she gives him these golden spoons. Christopher Columbus's golden spoons. And he said, these are great. And she goes, those are the Spain spoons. Always eat with those. And so he does. So he goes and he eats with them. And he eats everything with them. He eats soups like minestrone, stracciatelle, Italian wedding soup, chowders, clam chowder, corn chowder. He eats.
What
he
other
eats,
types of Italian soups are there? Because I'm not familiar with the
all
Italian
kinds of,
cuisine.
There's all kinds of cheese soups. There's lemon rice soup, which is more of a Greek soup, really, but it's Mediterranean. He eats all kinds of soup. There's a soup he makes. It's a pasta romagnole, which is like a combination of Parmesan cheese and bread that's bound with egg, and then it's made into a pasta form, and that's usually cooked with like maybe
an escarole. Why is lemon rice soup is so
why,
good?
Why are we stalling? Why are we stalling? Why are you guys, you know, beating around the bush and stalling by making this fucking story long, and I have no time for bullshit.
Skinmaster, can I tell the story? You're going to keep interrupting.
No. I'm not interested in a retarded story about why Christopher Columbus eats all these Spain spoons bullshit. I want to know where the Spain spoons went.
Oh.
How much money you got paid for the Spain spoons.
Oh.
And when I'm going to get paid for the Spain spoons.
Well, there's a bit of a problem with that.
Oh, there's a bit of a problem with that, huh?
Yeah, because stuff that happened at the with Slugworth.
Stuff that happened with Slugworth. Well, that's what I need to know.
You want to tell the background first?
Right now.
Yeah. We got to tell the background first.
Okay, so for the
Fucking
so the Spain spoons bounced around. The Spain spoons bounced around from collector to collector to collector, where they finally ended up with my pal and yours, our producer of Windy City Heat, John Quincy Adams.
Good man.
He's a good man. He kept them in his safe, and I took them out of the safe to give them to Scaremaster. The reason being because Scaremaster was mad at me because I had accidentally given away his spoons at our chili cook-off. The chili cook-off was a great time. We all met at Scaremaster's house, and Dan won. We each made
you
a different
won
kind of
with
chili.
What? Taco Bell fucking or Jack in the Box fucking chili?
It was Wendy's.
Wendy's, there we go. Thank you. Wendy's chili.
Yeah, you
so
won.
You really didn't win because that wasn't real chili. That's fast food.
Scaremaster, can we stop talking about the chili and talk about the money?
Chili.
Can we stop talking about the chili?
You want to get back to the story? You want to just talk on about
we can talk about chili.
The money.
So I took the spoons and I sent them to Scaremaster. And then we found out that Quincy was like, oh, no, you can't send those because those are stolen now because you gave them to Scaremaster. So I said, uh-oh, because they're worth really a lot of money because they're the spoons that Christopher Columbus ate his pastina with. He ate his pasta ravioli.
He
ate his carbonara.
He
ate his linguine and clam sauce. He ate his penne vodka.
What?
Okay.
He ate food.
He ate food. And so, I mean, but all kinds of food, Scaremaster, and all kinds of like meats, lamb, chicken, beef, pork.
Okay. We get it.
All
right.
Fish, all the kinds of fish, salmon, dorado,
you
tuna,
can't eat fish with
swordfish,
spoons.
Halibut.
I got your point. Okay. Now, where's
mussels,
the money that you
shellfish
made from
too,
the spoons?
Shrimp. Langostino, lobster.
We know. We get it. We get
clams,
it. Okay?
All kinds of clams.
Little
clams. Steamer clams. Ipswich clams.
Oh, my fucking God. I don't want to say, oh, my fucking God. I just want to say, God. Where is the money?
I'm getting to it. You keep interrupting me to talk about stuff.
When you go to a movie, do you demand to see the ending when you just get there? Hey, how's this thing end? Do you do that?
This is not a movie. This is real life.
It is real life.
It's real life. It's definitely real life for sure.
God almighty.
Thank you, Scaremaster.
This is real.
Somebody has to say
real.
It.
This is 100% real. That's what's happening. So.
Thank you.
Let's get back to the real.
All right.
So, real life, John Quincy Adams got really mad that that someone had the spoons. And then I think he found out that Scaremaster had it. But you know who else found out that Scaremaster had the spoons was John Quincy Adams' big rival, Arthur Slugworth. And Arthur Slugworth started saying he wanted the spoons. So Arthur Slugworth reached out and said to Scaremaster, bring me the spoons. I'll give you a whole bunch of money. And Scaremaster said, no, thank you. I'm too scared. I'm going to send Dan and Moldon to get the money. So we went over to his house.
Did you talk to this guy?
He left a message. He said it. And so we went over to 7722 Reseda Boulevard.
In Reseda, California.
In apartment 102. By the way, how is your neighbor Jay across the hall doing?
My address like you always do. Stop giving out my address.
Okay, how's Jay? How's Jay doing across the hall?
You don't know Jay.
I do too know Jay. We met the other night.
Yeah, we met the other night,
but it's none of your business. I don't know.
He invited us to come over.
I don't know the guy.
if Mole and I stop by there and we knock on your door because we're having dinner at his place.
Will you come over and hang with us?
No, I'm not interested.
Well, Jay's a nice guy and he wants to party with us, so he's right across the hall. You might hear us over there.
I think he might have
not
a...
interested.
He might have a nose candy.
We're
going to
go smoke a Jay. Smoke a Jay with Jay.
I think he
I'm
has
gonna
a
tell
nose
him not
candy
to let you
problem.
In.
Why not?
Because I'm not interested and I don't want him interested.
Oh.
Why can't he? Oh, because he's your friend and we're not allowed to be
I
friends
don't,
with him?
No, he's not my friend. He's my neighbor and that's all.
Well, he's our friend. He's not our neighbor.
How's he your friend? Somebody
because we met him and he liked us.
We hit it off. Can't
yeah,
we hit it off
met
with somebody?
The other night.
Right.
Big fucking
well, how
deal.
How do you think you make friends? You meet
now.
Somebody and go like, yeah, let's
now.
Hang out.
Where's my like, dough, you pricks?
Listen, I think you're giving Jay an unfair shake here. You should give Jay can be more than a neighbor.
Jay's my neighbor. That's all
go
I know
Go over to
about
Jay's right now. Go knock on Jay's door.
Fuck you!
Ask
Show
him.
Me the money!
Okay. I'll tell you what happened.
God damn it, I'm tired of your shit! All of you, you pricks!
Can we tell you what happened? Can we tell you what happened?
So well, let's... Hey, you know
Get
what we should do?
Point.
Let's let Perry talk about what he thinks might have happened and what happened. Do you want to do that?
I have no clue.
Okay, what happened that night? Did we come over to your place?
Yeah, you came over and you acted like a couple of assholes.
What are you talking about? We came over, we got the spoons.
You were not allowed in my apartment. Only Don was allowed to use
Thank
the pisser.
You.
Why yep. wasn't I allowed in?
Because I didn't want you in.
Well,
I didn't even want Mary Jane inside.
Hey, you,
I said,
mistake,
I wanted to let Don in
mistake,
to use the fucking restroom.
Mistake.
That was it.
Mistake.
But no, all three of you come
no,
into my apartment.
No,
Mary Jane,
you
made
you
me come inside the skateboard.
You wanted us to...
Then you leapfrogged onto my mom's dresser.
You
Thank
made,
God you didn't break the glass.
You made us come into side
you
the
wanted
skateboard.
To sign the skateboards.
Fuck
you!
You didn't want to sign. You didn't want to sign skateboards.
Please, please come inside.
Sign skateboards. You
that was
want...
outside. You only signed one board.
You're welcome. How much money do
Thank
we make
you.
Off that? How much money will we make off that? How much money will we
and
make
you
off?
You fucked up my Windy City Heat DVD.
How?
You didn't even sign it correctly. You fucking scribbled all over it like it was a fucking... Like you're in, not even in first grade. Like
you know much,
I'm not in first grade. I'm not
you know
in
how
first
much,
grade.
You know how much more valuable it is now that you've talked about it?
Yeah.
People will want it. You could sell that.
To get done with this fucking conversation.
Yeah, really.
Show me the money.
Do you want a scam master?
Or is
almost,
it that you have $0?
Do you want
to
hear the story?
And all you want to do is fuck around. Fuck around. Fuck around. I'm sick and tired of your bullshit story. I want to
hear
the real
story. Can I make a, you
want to
hear something? Okay,
stop. Mr. Adams.
Shut up. Shut
Mr.
up.
Mr. Adams, come in here. Hold on a second. Mr. Adams isn't it? Hold on. Mr. Adams, hold on. Let me get him. He's in the other room.
I want to see money.
One more.
Or you have no money. You're just out to fuck me.
That's not true.
Yeah, it is.
By the way, can I just say this? You'll hear how you fucked us over.
Hello.
I didn't
hello.
Fuck anybody over.
Mr. Adams, come here. Mr.
I fucked no one over.
Mr. Adams, are you there?
I'm in the bathroom.
Are you at Mr. Adams' place?
Yeah. Hold on.
Perry was about to do Foghorn Leghorn.
Oh, do it, Scam Master.
Come on, do it, please, Perry. You know it'd be funny if you said Foghorn Leghorn, telling us I want to see my money.
I want to see my money. Show me my money.
That
Show me my
awesome,
money, sonny.
Where are those spoons? I want to know about the spoons. What happened with the spoons?
Hello. Oh. I'm
hello,
out
Mr.
The
Adams.
Bathroom. Who's there?
It's me, Don.
Hello,
loves. Well, listen, I must say that is quite something that happened the other night, I believe, with those spoons.
What happened?
Petty, you don't know what happened.
I had no idea what happened.
Well,
other
I'll
than the
what...
fact that Mole broke the box and that spoons went all over the fucking sidewalk.
Hey, Mr. Adams, is...
May I speak? Go ahead. Go
can
ahead.
I just ask this? If Mole's there, maybe we should show a video first.
What video would you like to share?
Of what happened the other night, or do you think it should follow you?
Probably an edited video to make it look like I broke the box.
Oh, do you have a video? Well,
yes.
May I tell you what happened with me?
Go ahead, please.
All right. Well, I just left the police station.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my
now
God.
What?
I was called to the police. Well, the good news is they found my spoons.
Okay.
The bad news is they found them.
The box was broken.
Listen to me. Listen to me and don't speak for a moment.
That was Don's fault.
Was it my fault? How was it my fault?
I need
how
to
was it?
Right. You gave the box to Mole.
I'm going to hang up. I'm going to hang up. May I speak uninterrupted, Perry?
Go ahead. Go ahead, speak, Mr. Adams.
Good news, they found my spoons. Bad news, they found them at the site of a murder.
They found them at the site of a murder?
Yes, at the site of
what?
Listen to me.
Who got murdered?
I was called into the police because they had found my spoons. My spoons were covered with blood. There was a murdered person there. And that murdered person.
Oh, my God.
And that murdered person, I'll give you one guess who it was.
I have no idea.
It was Arthur Slugworth, dead to the gills.
What?
Listen to me. This is serious now. Listen to me.
What happened?
I'm going to tell you what happened. Apparently, the police found... were alerted to the sounds of screaming. They came to the scene. They found my spoons, which I had been looking for. High-profile uh-huh. case. They called uh-huh. me in. The spoons okay. are covered in blood, and they kept them as evidence because they wanted to dust them for fingerprints.
Oh, my God.
Now listen to me.
Did he pay the money first?
Listen to me. The spoons were dusted for fingerprints.
Okay.
They kept the spoons from me. I just returned. They just called me to pick up the spoons. I just picked them up.
My prints are on those spoons.
Listen to me. They gave the complete, and I got, this is 10 minutes ago, I got the forensic results of the spoons. Would you like to hear?
Go ahead.
I'm reading now. From the forensic pathologist. Who uh-huh. found that the box of spoons was handled that night by two gentlemen, it says gentlemen, and they were wearing gloves.
Hear that?
Hey, I was wearing gloves. Dan, were you wearing gloves?
I was wearing gloves, too.
I was wearing gloves,
no,
too.
No, you weren't.
Did you guys kill this guy at the scene?
Listen to me. Listen to me. Listen to me.
I hope it was after he paid you.
Listen to me. The police held the spoons to find other fingerprints. And they found other fingerprints. Someone
okay.
who handled the spoons but was not wearing gloves. And guess whose fingerprints?
I have nothing to do with this.
Oh, really? Well, Perry, can I tell you what happened?
Go ahead.
The police knew that fingerprint... The only fingerprint they could pull off the box of spoons was the killer.
Well, I didn't kill nobody.
You need to listen to me, Perry.
Go on.
However.
Go on, keep talking.
Scare Master, those are your fingerprints on there.
No, they're not. How could they be my fingerprints? I never touched those spoons.
You touched them all the time with
I have face. Nothing to do with this.
You handed them to me with bare hands. What are you talking about?
My gloves were on.
You weren't wearing gloves, dude.
My gloves were on when
no,
I walked
in. I got a picture of us in front of the thing. You're not
I wasn't
gloves.
Even in Chinatown.
It doesn't matter. They're just talking about fingerprints.
I was in my apartment.
It doesn't matter, dude. They're talking about fingerprints.
Let them talk about fingerprints. When you guys were here, I had gloves on. And my mask on.
Look at that picture right there.
No gloves, dude. You're not wearing gloves, Scaremaster. You weren't wearing gloves that day.
So what?
See the picture?
My fingerprints have nothing to do with the murder of Slugworth. I wasn't even there. I was nowhere near this Slugworth person.
I know it's circumstantial.
I don't even know who this Slugworth person is.
Can you prove it?
Can you prove that you weren't there? Because you're the
I'm right fucking here. I didn't even leave my fucking apartment.
They don't know that.
My publicist is my alibi.
No.
My apartment manager is my alibi. No. My next door neighbor is my alibi.
No. Even Jay says he doesn't remember when you left. We called Jay.
I never even left. Fuck this guy. You called Jay. You guys are nothing but fucking scam artists and liars.
May I continue, please? May I continue?
Go ahead, Mr. Adams.
Go on.
Those fingerprints would indict whomsoever they were. But there was a problem. May I continue, Perry?
Keep talking.
As they tried to lift the fingerprints, they found that they could not, because the forensic pathologist determined that something must have happened to the box of spoons. To the spoons and the box, that they were rubbed against the ground, either asphalt or sidewalk or the
Thank
street.
Thank you, because and the mole dropped them on the sidewalk
And the fact that they rubbed against the sidewalk made those prints unable to be read. All they were able to tell was that the person was obese. They were not able to tell who they were.
That's all bullshit. That's a fucking lie. And I'm not obese, okay?
What I'm telling you, Perry, is however those spoons hit the sidewalk, that saved you. That made your fingerprints unable to be read.
Good.
Were you smart?
Where's the fucking money?
Well, the money.
Can I ask Mole something?
Oh my God. I'm on the fucking phone with you an hour.
Okay, that's not true.
What is it?
I'd like to show a video. And then
not interested in your fucking video.
Please, you'll be interested in this.
What's the video?
Would you like to show the video, or can I tee it up with a little tune?
Oh, maybe you could tee it up with a little tune.
All right. I would just like to say
no tunes. I'm not interested in your fucking music.
Relax.
Your stupid music.
I'm very, very happy. I'm very, very happy that everybody is all right.
Oh, my God. Your gay songs suck, okay?
May I please just...
That's not nice.
You can't even sing.
May I please let you know how I'm feeling?
I got gas.
May I please let you know how I'm feeling?
Please, let's hear your song.
This is supposed to be a fucking meeting. Let's find out where the spoons are, as well as where the male money is.
Let's buy
my beautiful Spain spoons. He thought he'd give it a try and get my beautiful Spain spoons. He called Don and Mole and told them to come to Chinatown. And then he died. Yes, he died. Slugworth sure did pay for my beautiful
Why are you talking about your
Spain spoons. They're back in my safe place, my beautiful Spain spoons. Slugworth got stabbed in the face for my beautiful Spain spoons. They were covered in blood, and the box was broken at the seams.
Why are you singing about this?
Yes, he died.
Why would you be singing about this?
When he tried to buy my beautiful Spain spoons.
You're a mental patient. You're sick.
To me and to
Who
me
are you talking
alone.
To?
Fucking Quincy. Quincy,
they
was disgusting.
The spoons Columbus used to eat his minestrone. He was Italian like Perry, so he ate like a slob. He had constant diarrhea.
If you're singing about your spoons, well, I mean, If you're in love with your fucking spoons. Place
with my beautiful Spain spoons. They are.
Why are you singing about this?
Stop. Just stop, Perry. Stop.
Who Perry thought he'd buy a car and just drive away. But not today.
Oh my God.
He's got to stay.
Oh my God.
That payday went up and away when I got my beautiful Spain spoons. Spain spoons.
Oh, yeah, they're more
gold. The Nicholas brothers, they have their short shorts and their belly tees and tiny knives. Oh, they're stabbing each other. Stop it, you know. Oh, look at them.
I'm not involved
really enjoying
with the Nicholas brothers.
Don't get that blood all over them. And they're dancing and stabbing and dancing and stabbing. And I've got my Spain spoons. Thoughts. Thoughts.
Disgusting. Horrible. Absolutely horrible. It sucked. Why is he singing about this? Why is he singing about this? It's sick. You and Don both lost those fucking spoons.
You
and then not only lost them, but you fucking piece of garbage, you fucking dropped the box on the sidewalk like the Spain spoons are nothing but trash.
Yeah, but they wiped your fingerprints off so you don't have to go to jail for murder. That turned out to be great.
Fuck you. I'm not going to jail for murder.
Not now. Not now.
Hey.
I wasn't even in Chinatown.
Stop.
I wasn't even fucking there.
Shut the fuck up.
You shut the fuck up, you cow-faced piece of garbage.
Yeah, you.
Where's my money, fuckface?
I'm not telling you, no.
Hold on a second. Mr. Adams has a
question.
You're
a thief.
What is it, Mr. Adams? What is it? I just simply wanted to ask why the spoon didn't invite the other utensils to his party.
Why?
I'm not going to get paid.
Oh, I know. Because he fork at. He fork at. The spoon fork at.
That's always
why
funny.
Are you guys joking
How
about
are you
this?
Always funny.
Because you're out to fuck me?
It's not. I think, Perry, that's I wild. Think this is very entertaining.
It's personally. Not entertaining to me.
To me,
this
it
is not
is.
Entertainment to me.
I,
you're to a fucking prick.
I think to a lot of people it is.
Spain's
a lot of people, huh? Oh, yeah, you made this into a fucking podcast, which I am not interested in doing. With you ever again, right. You motherfucker! Where's my fucking money?
Calm down, man. Calm down, dude. You're so tense.
Let's show
money or the show's over!
Shut up. I'm trying
one
to...
More time,
I,
and one the more show's
time.
Over.
One more time. If you fucking do this, you
one
get nothing
more
of what
time.
You got. You get nothing. There's
goodbye.
No you're going to do that? Fine.
Where's my fucking dough, you
I
prick?
I ask you to shut up. Shut your fucking mouth. Now, I think we should show...
Were you talking to Scaremaster or me? Because that was really intense to you.
I was talking to Perry.
Oh, that's good.
And what I'd like to do right now is I'd like to show a little video. And I know that Perry watches.
Show the video.
Go ahead.
I want to see.
There's Don and Mole in Chinatown, August 25th, 2020. Chinese music playing in the background. All right, you're both wearing masks. Mole's got sunglasses on at night. And Don has the spoons in his hand. You guys are way too loud for a deal like this.
Don't tell us how to do business.
Yeah, we know what we're doing, dude.
The whole fucking place knows you're there because you're so fucking loud.
So what's happening now? Tell everybody.
God, you're gayer than shit.
Describe what's happening, please.
When you do a deal like this, you're supposed to be quiet, you fucks.
Don't tell me how to do business, fuckwad. I've asked you please to describe what you're seeing.
Why are you wearing white? You don't wear white to a fucking late night meeting if you're supposed to be meeting somebody.
Not after Labor Day, you don't.
I want to wear as many white clothes before the summer ends as I possibly can.
That's true. Yeah, you're very Hamptons.
Oh my! Is that?
Will you describe what's happening, please?
Don's getting a phone call. It's Slugworth. Slugworth is watching you?
That was weird.
He wants his spoons from Spain. Perry Francis. My middle name's not Francis.
What is it?
Frank.
It's Frank, you fuck.
Same thing. Isn't Frank short for Francis?
Yes, it is.
I'm not fat. Slugworth called me fat. I'm not fat.
Yes, you are.
Fuck you. All right, Don's doing the deal. And Mole's going to give him a knife? Oh, God. One of those pocket knives with a nail file and a nail scissors.
Scissors.
Oh, please. I used to run around with a knife like that for the print shop to open up boxes.
Must be nice.
Those were the days.
Yeah.
You don't use a knife like this in a deal like this.
Why not? Hey, don't tell me how to do
20
business.
20 minutes later. Now it's 20 minutes later. Don's got blood all over him. Oh, my God. Don killed Slugworth.
We don't know
Don
that.
Don killed Slugworth. Don killed Slugworth.
Don't say
you
that.
You don't know that.
Don's covered in blood. Don's covered in blood. He killed Slugworth. Show this to the police.
You don't know that.
Show this to the police. And Mole stole the spoons. Mole stole the spoons.
I didn't steal spoons.
Mole stole the spoons. And you got blood all over your hands. Oh, my God. Barris has got... Where's the money? Where's the money? Don killed Slugworth. He's got blood all over him. Where's the money? Where's the fucking money? I'm not understanding.
Okay.
Mole says I'm understanding.
Yeah, I think you are.
Holy fuck. Don is covered in blood. He's got a handprint in blood on his shirt.
Where I was grabbed.
There's no money. There's no money. There's no spoons. Where's the fucking money?
Hey, can I say one thing? Scaremaster.
You want to know?
We're safe.
Where's the fucking money?
Dan and I are safe.
Where is the fucking money?
Right. Let me explain what happened.
You killed the guy.
I'll tell you what I remember. What I remember is that we went in there, Scaremaster. Slugworth was there. There were 9 duffel bags of money. There were 9 duffel bags of money. And he said, let me see the spoons. And so,
where's the duffel bags?
Do you want to hear the story? You want to interrupt
him? Talk.
Okay, one more time. We walked in there. There were 9 duffel bags of money. Slugworth goes, where are the spoons?
No, that's not the first thing he said.
Oh, he goes, oh, I remember what he said. He started talking about Dan's eyes.
I don't give a fuck about Dan's eyes.
But it was a compliment. As I walk in there, oh, there's
you fucking
those beautiful
murdered somebody.
Eyes. Can I finish what I'm saying?
You're a murderer, and I always called you a murderer, and you killed somebody.
Can I finish what I was saying?
Finish what you were saying.
There they are, those beautiful eyes in person. They're even more beautiful.
Yeah, that's a fucking deal. I give a rat's ass.
And he kept staring at
demonic blue eyes. Your satanic blue eyes.
So pick it up from there.
Slugworth kept staring at Dan. He was just staring at him, staring. And I went, we got to do this deal or what? And he's like, oh, yeah, yeah. And he shook it off. And he goes, where are the spoons? And so Dan hands him the spoons. And he takes the spoons. And for a second, he just stares at Dan's eyes again for a minute. And just shakes his head like, wow. He's like, wow.
Oh, my God.
And did so he say anything? Because I remember you went like.
Like,
Slugworth's a faggot, okay?
He just kept going, boy, oh, boy. Boy,
Slugworth's
oh, boy.
A faggot. Slugworth's a faggot. He's just a faggot just like you and fucking Quincy. All right? I give a rat's ass about Don's eyes. I don't give a shit about Don or his fucking faggot ass eyes. All I care about is the money you guys are stealing from me.
In all fairness, he's trying to tell you what happened. And you
I am done with this conversation.
No, listen.
I don't find out where the fucking money is.
I'm trying to tell you.
Where are the duffel bags now? You've been bitch fucking around for a fucking
hour.
Shut
up, Perry. Will you quit interrupting him? God.
Oh, my God.
Yeah. Oh, my God is right. Go, continue, Mo.
Scaremaster, you're impatient like you're at a Wendy's drive-thru right
because
now.
Because I'm waiting for you to tell me what you did with the fucking
give
money.
Give me the food. Give me the food. I want the food. Give me the food. Okay. So, where was I? Queen Isabella in Spain.
Jacking off. Columbus. That's where you've been.
We had gotten to the point where Slugworth sees my eyes.
Oh, he sees his eyes. And he's staring at Dan's eyes. And he's
I
like,
am
boy,
not
oh, boy.
Concerned about boy, your oh, eyes. Boy. I'm only concerned about the money.
Okay, I'm
where
trying to tell you.
Is the money? I give a rat's ass about this Queen Isabella bitch from fucking Spain. That was 1492. We're talking about 2020 and the fucking money you both owe me. If I didn't give you those fucking spoons, you wouldn't get shit.
Okay, continue on, Mo.
Okay. So Slugworth takes his spoons, okay, he takes his spoons, and he looks, and he's walking over the table, open, and he turns around, and he goes to our dad, he goes, one more time, let's just get one more look at those peepers. And Dan,
what, do you remember what I did?
Oh, my God.
Yeah, he winked at him, and he kind of put, Dan
oh
put like
God,
his finger
guys,
on his chin.
All you wanted to do was waste
his finger
my
on
fucking
his chin.
Time.
just like that. And
Slugworth's
started going,
a faggot, we
Slugworth
get it.
Started going, boy, oh, boy, boy, oh, boy. And so then, so Slugworth goes, I got to get back to business. And he kept glancing back at Dan. And so then
back Slugworth, to business.
Then Slugworth opens up the thing of spoons, right? And he goes,
I don't give a fuck.
You don't
he
care?
Goes, Jesus,
why,
fucking tell
why
the
do you
fucking
have
story
to tell
right.
This guy.
Stop jacking off. He goes. How long does it fucking take to get to the fucking point,
I'm
you goddamn
to tell
son
you,
of a bitch?
Scaremaster, I really want to tell you what happened, dude. I really do.
Well, stop fucking beating around the bush. It's a fucking hour and 20 minutes.
I'm not trying to. You just keep interrupting, Scaremaster. Okay,
I'm 100% behind.
Where were we? Okay, the Queen Isabella.
You're the worst
ship,
fucking storyteller.
Soup, different seafood. Dan put his finger on his chin. Eyes.
I don't give a fuck.
Eyes.
Where is the money?
I can't tell you if you keep interrupting me. Do you want to hear?
His best.
Okay. Okay, Queen Isabella.
If I hear the eyes again, the show's over.
What do you mean? Hey, that was a big
part. It was
part.
A key part of the story, Perry.
That means nothing! I demand to know where the fucking money is!
Okay. So Slugworth takes the spoons over to a table, right? And he slowly opens them up. But the box was kind of, the hinges of the box were kind of broken for some reason. The whole top of the box was kind of busted.
I know when that happened.
Yes, because of you, you fuck!
Agree to disagree.
Only you! You fucking threw the box on you. Actually, you opened the box, you checked them, you looked at it, you closed it, but you didn't set the latches on it. And you walked over to the sidewalk and you dropped the box, and the spoons went everywhere, and the box broke.
Not what happened.
That's an old fucking box.
I tried to toss
it to Dan. Son of a bitch.
Tried to toss
it to Dan. That's exactly what fucking happened. You lying motherfucker. You guys are a waste of my time. I'm hanging up on you.
Do you want to hear what happened? Let me tell you what happened, Scaremaster. Stop interrupting. Listen, so here's what happens. So Slugworth says, he takes the spoons, right? And he goes, boy, I hope these spoons are as gold as your eyes are blue, Dan. And,
what?
I think we lost them. I just want Scaremaster. I want him to know what happened. He deserves to know what happened.
He at least deserves to know, even though he
look.
He deserves to know what happened. Because listen, Scaremaster
explain it all to me.
Okay, start from the beginning because every time you called
me, Dan, I screwed up.
What's my new name?
It's Kristaff. It's Kristaff. Okay. So Kristaff and I went into the place.
What the fuck is Kristaff?
That's Kristaff. My name. I changed my name to Kristaff.
You changed your name because you're a liar and a fucking killer.
Okay, can I tell you what happened? So Slugworth looks at Kristaff and he says, Kristaff, your eyes are so blue. They're so blue, dude. Boy, oh boy. Boy, oh boy. And Kristaff,
I'm showing that video to the police.
Did he ask me to put my finger under my chin, or did I do that on my own?
Yeah, I think you did it on your own, and he just went wild.
Get to the point, you fuckers.
So Kristaff is standing there.
Dom Barris, you mean? He's standing there,
and Slugworth takes the spoons, and he opens the spoons, but the top of them is broken because you dropped them.
My hands weren't even on them.
Right. You know what? I watched the video. You dropped them, Perry.
I did not drop them!
Okay. So let's move on. It didn't matter.
I edited it to make it look like I dropped them.
Didn't matter.
These fucking lying thieves.
Doesn't matter.
Same thing with the fucking table in the
Scaremaster.
Fucking
movie. Doesn't matter. One of us jumped
20, 30 feet away.
Can he please tell the story, or do you want to keep playing this game about something that happened a long time ago?
Game?
Why'd you change it to the Windy City Heat? We're talking about this currently. Why'd you talk about Windy City Heat? Answer that question.
Get to the point.
Pick it up, Mole.
Okay. So Kristaff is standing there with his finger on his chin and like batting his eyelashes a little bit, you know?
Harry,
and so,
look.
Like that. Just like that. Like that.
I don't give a
see,
fuck.
See what Kristaff, look what Kristaff is doing. See what Kristaff is doing?
You mean Don Barris.
Agree.
I don't care. I'm not interested.
Okay, so
it's 7:47. We got on the phone at a little after 6. Why the fuck are we on the phone till almost 7 p.m.?
Okay, well, hold on.
I want to know where the fucking money is.
I'm telling you. I'm going to tell you. So Slugworth takes the spoons and then he starts looking at them. He like pushes the spoons aside and he starts looking. He's tearing them apart. He's like, where is it? He's screaming, where is it? Where is it? Where is it? And he looks at Dan. He goes, and Dan's like, and Dan bats his eyes really quick. He's like, I don't know what you're talking about. And he's like, where is it? And he goes, who, me? And he grabs Dan. And then right when that happened, I was wearing these AirPod Pros, you know those little AirPod Pros, Scaremaster?
Don't give a shit about your AirPod Pros.
They're really awesome.
So fucking what?
They were fire.
Explain to me what you did with the fucking money. I don't want to hear a goddamn story that's going to take 2 fucking hours to tell.
You know why it takes 2 hours? Because you keep interrupting, telling them.
Keep interrupting. I can get
wrong.
I would have been through the whole thing.
Then shut up and listen. Shut up and listen. Go ahead, Mole.
Because you don't know how to tell a story.
Shut up. See, you can't shut your mouth. You can't shut your mouth.
Let's see if you can go a whole minute, Scaremaster, okay? Start the clock. So I'm looking at these AirPod Pros, and they're really cool, but they're small, and they have a little R or an L on them because that's for the right ear and the left ear, and I didn't realize that, and so they were in the wrong ear.
Oh,
so I was trying to look to see which one was the R and which one was the L. And I'm
13
looking, I'm like,
seconds.
It was because it was kind of dark in there, and I'm looking to see which one was the right one.
It makes no fucking difference about these stupid AirPods.
It does. It does. If you put the wrong one in, they don't line up with your ear canal, and you don't get the ultimate. You don't get that really rich sound. You know?
No shit, so, Sherlock.
Right. That's what I'm saying. And so I put the AirPods in, and I got them, and I'm like, great. And I looked up, and I was like, great. The AirPods are working. I looked up, and Slugworth was dead. And Dan's like, we got to get out of here.
That makes no sense. That makes absolutely no sense.
Let me explain the missing part.
Unless Don can explain why he's got blood all over his fucking shirt. All
right, I'll explain.
Here's the deal.
He slipped.
No. Do you want to listen or no? Do you want to listen to my side? Or do you want to
You
keep
show me the cash right the fuck now?
I'm not going
or I
to.
Send this video to the police.
Don's in charge.
Don's not in charge when there's blood all over your fucking body. All
right, now Chris, do you want to hear how that happened or no?
Let Chris stop.
You're
going
to be behind bars.
Christoph, tell your version. Start with Queen Isabella.
I'm not going back that far. Now, I'm in this office, and I'm not into doing dudes, but when someone compliments you...
Neither am
you,
I.
When, yeah, but,
you're more into it than this dude.
Yeah. When someone compliments you, it's always nice, no matter what. And he is making a big thing. Slugworth is, oh, those eyes... Big fucking
deal about your fucking gay ass eyes, you fucking flaming faggot. Find out or tell me, not find out, tell me when you're going
to
bring
to
back
you,
the money.
Tell you.
As well as show me the fucking money.
He's trying to tell you, Scaremaster.
I don't want you to beat around the bush any longer for 2 fucking hours.
Big story.
Okay, may I finish?
I'm told it was a fucking meeting, and you turned it into a goddamn podcast, and I'm not interested in your fucking faggot-ass podcast.
Speaking of podcasts, Dan, what time is it?
It's time we do the best thing on the podcast. It's time for a little thing I like to call Mole Play.
Oh, my God.
Mole Play, let's play Mole Play. Mole Play, let's play Mole Play. Mole play.
Okay, so what's going to happen on today's Mole Play?
Okay, today's Mole Play, there's a lot of questions about what really happened and who jumped on the credenza.
Yes,
let's
finally
find out who jumped on Scary Perry's mom's credenza in this episode.
You did, like a leapfrog.
We head to Scaremaster's apartment where the big three are hanging out and signing skateboards. Scaremaster, you're going to play me. I'm gonna play Dan, and Dan's gonna play you. Ready, Mole Play.
I'll do it if I get the money.
I'm Christoph. Hey,
I don't know a Christoph.
That's me.
You're Mole. You got to be Mole, Scaremaster. You can do.
I'm Mole.
Yeah,
climb on the credenza.
I'm gonna jump on your credenza like an asshole.
You better not. You better not. Don't get in my apartment. No one's having popcorn.
I am because I'm a piece of shit.
I'm so mean to you guys. Even though
all I care about is doing drugs, smoking weed, and shooting up with drugs.
You're my best friend. You can jump on the credenza. I love you, Mole.
My father is a rogue cop, and you're an asshole.
I don't love you like that. But, you know, I don't love you like the way I love other dudes.
Who are you?
I love you as a best friend, man.
I thought you were playing me.
Oh, that's right. I'm sorry.
You're
Christoph. Can't even get this straight.
Well, I was.
Okay, you be Scaremaster. All right, Christoph.
Forget it. It's done.
I'll be Christoph. I'm Christoph. I've got the bluest eyes in all the land.
I don't want to hear about your fucking blue eyes. Where's the money?
Scaremaster, I want to give you lots of
opportunities.
My name
is Walter Mole Molinsky.
Sure,
I'm a fucking loser and a drug addict.
Else.
Get out of here, Mole!
Hey, why don't we all climb up on top of the credenza?
I'm going to jump up and down in your furniture because I don't give a shit about you. Nor do I even respect you.
Scaremaster, that's no way to talk to your best friend.
Get out of my place!
And I'm also going to steal your silverware.
Why are you going to do that, Mole?
Because I'm a disrespectful fucking drug addict.
And that's Mole Play.
Mole Play, Mole Play, let's play Mole Play. Mole Play, Mole Play, let's play Mole Play. Mole Play!
Where's the fucking money?
I don't think there's time to get to that.
Yes, there is.
Well, there would have been if you didn't...
Yes, there fucking is! Where is my money?
All right, well, I think we learned a lot.
You motherfuckers better tell me where that money is.
Did I tell you when Slugworth talked about my beautiful eyes?
Fuck your eyes, you fucking queer. I give a flying fuck about your faggot-ass eyes. God, you're a fucking faggot. Oh, my God.
Well, if that you're going to be that way, we should just end the podcast.
Anybody want to give their social media more?
You'll never see me again if you don't give me my fucking money. Walter Malinsky, we're done. We're done.
Facebook. And
we're done.
You can also look for me as perrysbestfriend.com.
I'm not your best friend. Never have been, never will be, and never,
also,
ever,
I'm
ever want to have anything to do with
you. Can I make an announcement really quick?
We are done.
Scaremaster, I'm not interrupting you. Listen, we want to tell you what's happening. Mole's Poke Bowls is expanding.
Where's the money?
And now we are joining forces with Mole's Turkey Rolls.
So where's the money?
At our roadside places, they're going to be a combined restaurant.
Where's the money?
Mole's Poke Bowls and Turkey Rolls.
He's giving his...
Your fucking Mole's bullshit. Goodbye.
Poke Bowls and Turkey Rolls, Scaremaster.
We're done. We're done.
Hold on. You want to know? Do you want to know, yes or no, or do we just end?
Yeah, I want to fucking know.
Then say you don't want it to end.
I don't want what to end?
The podcast to end so you can find out what
Give happened. Me my fucking money!
Oh, the money's
God
gone.
God damn you!
Gone. It's covered with blood. We forgot the money. We
have it's 8 o'clock!
It. Yeah.
Fuck you!
Perry.
Fuck you, you son of a bitch! Where is my money?
All right. Please, settle down for 1 second, and I'll tell you exactly what happened. All right. When he found...
You murdered someone! That's what fucking happened! You murdering motherfucker! Where's my $1 billion? You piece of dog shit!
Chris, Dad,
$1 billion! Where is it?
If I open my mouth and you interrupt me again, the show will be over. We'll send it back to Don and Mary Jane in the studio. May I talk now, please? Okay. All right. So when Slugworth was going crazy because you didn't put the ticket... to the new world on because you lost
what?
It. It wasn't
the ticket
in the
was
box.
Underneath.
No, it wasn't.
The ticket was underneath the
no,
the,
it
the
was
Madden
not.
Box.
All right, yeah,
yes,
that's
it
why,
was.
That's
yes,
why
it was. Then you
that's
stole
why,
it.
No, Perry,
then you stole it.
Perry, listen to me.
The ticket was right in the box.
I'm gonna tell
exactly
you
where it was when I saw it originally.
No, it wasn't in there, Scaremaster. That's why.
Yes, it was.
Out.
That's why he brought a gun, and when he took
then you
the gun
guys
out,
stole the ticket.
No, I did not. Perry, do you want to listen or do you want to keep interrupting? I'm trying to tell you.
You
what
robbed
happened.
Me.
I didn't.
Because I don't have the ticket.
Perry, there was no ticket, and he went crazy, and I had to use my.
You
knife
have the
on
ticket.
Him. No, I don't. And we.
The way Mole fucking broke the box.
No, the ticket. No, we never had the ticket, man. Never
had the
ticket.
Hey, you know what?
But it didn't fall in the street.
What
no,
you
it,
should
no.
do. After the podcast, you should go out on the road and see if the ticket's out there. Because
I'll go out there after the show's over. But I know for a fact that it's not out there because it was in the bottom portion of the box. When Mo broke the box in two and we picked up the spoons,
there.
You stole the ticket.
Okay, you're accusing me of doing something I didn't do. I'm trying to tell you the truth. I almost lost my life.
You're a murderer and a fucking thief.
Hey, but you know what? What else we are? Best friends.
Never in a million years! You'll never see me again!
Well, I have to say, what a high-energy show that was. I believe that someone was quoted when they first heard it. That was Perry on 10 the entire show. Do you think that's true, Mary Jane?
I don't think a human being could have yelled any more than Perry did in that show.
He did yell a lot, and I don't feel bad. He was going to have me go out there and possibly get murdered, and he at first didn't want to pay me a dime. You know, he did order people around a lot. And I still don't think he gets it. I'm in charge.
Don, today is the 978th day. You've worn a different T-shirt on a different day.
Yes, it is. We're getting near 1,000 days that I've been doing this.
Did anyone send you any T-shirts this week?
Well, let's see. As a matter of fact, I happen to know that there were some. Now, Mary Jane,
I have a t-shirt for you because there's one guy, and I like this. Awful Oil from this psycho Billy band. I've never heard that kind of music. The Brainiacs. And he gave a shirt to both you and I. Here's your shirt.
Thank you. Oh, I love it.
We'll have to take a picture of you in it and put it online for these people. This guy was, I'm going to read the letter he wrote. Hi, Don. My name is Ollie, and I'm a huge fan. I sent a couple t-shirts of my psychobilly band in Portland, Oregon called The Brainiacs. There's one for you and one for the beautiful. He put a lot of U's in there. Mary Jane. The big three in the Simply Don family of entertainment has kept us laughing for hundreds of hours and thousands of miles while on the road touring. Thanks for everything you do. Then he started by saying, it ain't quarantine. Awful Ollie. And that was from Awful Ollie. So thank you, Ollie. That was really nice. We also thank received, you. And we'll get a t-shirt of you on there very soon. This comes from a no-name person that didn't say anything, from Commerce Township, Michigan. What township did I come from in Michigan, Mary Jane?
Saginaw.
Saginaw Township's exactly right. He sent me a Black Perry t-shirt, and people seem to like that. Scott Norman sent a cream t-shirt that says, is it G-U-A-Guana? G-U-A-N-A?
Juana.
He sent a cream t-shirt that said Jamaica bat guano. Guano? Is that how you say it?
I'm really not sure, but I think it's wonderful he sent you a t-shirt.
I do too. Thank you, Mary Jane. And Garrett Shea, who's becoming a real pal. I see this guy on the nightly Instagram show that I do. And he gave me a t-shirt of Dennis Hopper from one of my favorite movies ever. What movie is that, Mary Jane?
Blue Velvet.
Exactly. And Garrett Shea gave that to me when we went out to dinner with him and Amber.
So what's going to happen with the Spain spoons?
Well, I don't know. If you want to get in touch with us on the social media, Mary Jane, how would they get in touch with you?
Well, most importantly, if any of the fans out there would like to contribute to Don Bear's Making It to 1,000 t-shirts, please send 2XL tees to Don Barris. You have to put the name Don Barris, 7190 Sunset Boulevard, number 153, Los Angeles, California, 90046. Also, every single Monday night at the World Famous Comedy Store at 10 p.m., except for when we're on the quarantine COVID thing, but you can still see the Ding Dong Show every single Monday night at 10:30 p.m. on YouTube channel Simply Don, the podcast network YouTube. That's 10:30 p.m. California time. On Facebook, please join the Big Three Fan Club, Simply Don, the podcast fan club, and the Ding Dong Show fan club. Also, there's a Reddit, SDTPN, and a Discord, Simply Don or something. I don't know. Corky did that.
Simply Don, the Discord. And according to Corky, we're going to be doing some live stuff in there that could be cool with Ding Dongers, Big Three, lots of people. So join that. But Mary Jane, let's talk about you. How about you? How could they get in touch with you?
On Instagram, A with the circle, THESMOKING, MARYJNE. And for Twitter, after the A with the circle, please remove the THE. Thank you. Do you have any social media you'd like to share, Don?
Well, yes, I do. I would like people to follow me on my Twitter at SimplyDon1. I would like people to follow me on my Instagram at SimplyDon1. SimplyDon1 is also where you would go when you're trying to follow me on Periscope. Mary Jane, time to say goodbye.
see me again! You fucking motherfuckers! We're done!
What do you mean?
Fuck you!
What do you mean?
Fuck you!
What are you talking about? What did I do?
All right, let's do this. Hey,
you robbed me,
Perry, you fuckers!
You fucking robbed me!
We're doing a promo. You don't want to do it like this.
A promo?
Yes.
There's no promo. You're a murderer, you piece of shit!
Hey, join us every week.
You'll never see me again.
This week on Simply Down the Podcast.
Fuck your promo. Fuck your promo.
It's the big thing.
We're not doing a fucking promo, you
We're back
fucking wacko.
At the first Sunday of every
Fuck
month.
You.
With
Fuck
the big,
you.
Fuck
you. The show's
podcast.
Over. The show's over.
Perry.
Fuck you.
We're
Fuck
just trying
you.
To do a
Fuck
promo.
You.
We
Fuck
resolved
you.
The Spain Bloods issue.
You'll never see me again. Show's over. You'll never see me again.
Well, I can't wait for the next one.